Hello, UCAR. Peter Christensen here, coming to you from the CEO's desk. Going to talk to you a little bit about if you were at the convention, a week and a half ago, we talked about personal assistants, licensed, unlicensed, transaction coordinators, kind of they all fit into the same rough box. Now, first off, there's no perfect definition for a personal assistant, a transaction coordinator, however you want to call it. But there is this question about licensed and unlicensed. And does it matter? Yes, it does matter. And there's a lot of confusion about this, probably too much confusion, in my opinion. It's pretty simple if we break it down. So an unlicensed assistant can do any unlicensed activities, and those are listed out in the admin rules. Stuff like taking an appointment over the phone as long as they didn't initiate the call, picking up keys, putting signs, stuff like that. But then you have licensed assistants. Now, what's the difference? Well, a licensed assistant has a real estate license, which means they can do anything that a real estate licensee can do. But the real confusion comes up when you have a transaction coordinator slash assistant that's doing work for more than one brokerage. It gets dicey because if they are licensed or unlicensed makes a big difference here. An unlicensed individual can perform unlicensed activities for a multitude of brokerages, right? Doesn't matter, doesn't have to be just one brokerage. However, a licensee acting in a licensee capacity can only work for one broker, right? When you have a real estate license, you're tied to one broker. And that means you cannot work for multiple brokerages. But what about that hybrid? The licensee who's doing non-licensee activities for more than one brokerage, does that exist? Can you do that? The simple answer is yes. Just like if you have a real estate license, you could still interior decorate for someone, another brokerage, because you're not doing a licensee activity. You could clean their bathrooms. You could wash their cars. Everything you do isn't a licensed activity just because you have a real estate license. The difference, though, is there's a fine line between licensee activity and unlicensed activity when it comes to assisting and transaction management. And so could you technically be a licensee and do unlicensed transaction coordinator activities for a multitude of brokerages? Yes, you technically could, right? As long as you never cross that line into licensee activity. It's dicey because that line is a fine one. You would also want to be very careful you were never doing transaction coordination for a file, a client that had a conflict with your own brokerage. Even though you're not acting as a licensed agent for your own brokerage, I think it's still problematic if a client from your brokerage has a transaction with a client from another brokerage and you're trying to be a transaction manager for the other brokerage. Does that make sense? We might need to diagram this. So there are some things to think about and to watch out for. Big one is getting paid. Licensee gets paid through the brokerage always. Non-licensed activity doesn't have to go through the brokerage, but it cannot be tied to the success of a transaction. Must be a set fee and not based on the success of the transaction. Can't look anything like commissions, right? That has to go through a brokerage and is a licensee activity. Hopefully this helps and doesn't hurt. If you listen to the presentation in the legal panel, hopefully this backs all that up. Remember, this is not legal advice. This is legal information only. If you need specific legal advice, please contact your attorney. And thanks for tuning in.